patience and sensitivity. I'm forgetting to write this down. This is huge, especially for our younger kids, but also for our teens. You have in your class maybe that kid that's habitually around mom's ankle. And maybe she comes out on the floor and you start to do something and then she kind of gets wigged and runs back to mom's ankle. Let her. It's fine. She's got time. Maybe she's four and this is the first time she's been in this kind of environment. If I force her to stay out with the class and it becomes a traumatic experience for her, she no longer wants to be in my class. If I let her come and go, as long as it's not disruptive to the rest of the class, then I have a much better chance of keeping her in and seeing her through to kids and teens. So allow the shy kids to check in with mom or dad if they need to. Allow them to sit out. I have the fake injury happens all the time, like, oh, my leg, you know. And I'm like, whatever. I have one girl that goes to the bathroom no less than 3 times every class. I could call her on it, or I just say, like, all right, sit out when you're ready to join us. As soon as we're doing something fun, she's right back in. As a caveat to that, if somebody sits out the whole class, I don't let them play the game. That's just me. That's a decision I've made because I say, it's cool if you want to sit out for a while, but make sure you get back in before we're done or else you're not going to be able to play the game. I mean, if they're legitimately hurt, that's different, but you can usually kind of get a sense for when somebody wants to just take a rest break. It's fine. Join us when you're ready.